While the sun rises from one side of the sky and sets on the other side of the sky, a flower gladly opens itself up to be admired all for the glory and honor of God's name. And just as diverse as nature is in its worship is how we as human beings are diverse in our worship. The title of the short devotion is the Three P's of Worship, and our key text is Psalms 100. The major four points that we pick out from this key text are: number one, shout for joy; number two, worship with gladness; number three, worship in thanksgiving and give praise to God. We are all blessed very differently, and sometimes we often get carried away in our own preferences of worship. Perhaps we prefer a different speaker as opposed to another, or perhaps we prefer a certain worship leader opposed to another. And the danger of this is that we start to give a lot of attention to ourselves and we forget what is happening in the house of the Lord. Now, we cannot fulfill a worship such as Psalms 100 without considering the following P's that are very important in ensuring that we have unity in our diverse ways of worship. The first P is the person, or rather object. Who is the person we are worshiping? Is it the speaker? Is it the worship leader? No. The person we need to worship is God. God is the object of worship because he is worthy, as told in Revelation chapter 4, verse 11. And the second P is purpose. What is the purpose of worship? Are we worshiping because we like the beats of the music? Are we worshiping because we like the speaker? Are we worshiping because our friends are there? No. The purpose of worship should be to glorify God and fellowship with him. Sometimes we get caught up in our own gifting. Sometimes we do worship just because we want to glorify ourselves or make ourselves look good in front of people. Some people will sing because they want to show off their voices. Some people will write poetry because they want to express how good they are, and they forget that the purpose of that worship should be to glorify God. And the third P is preference. Where does your preference to worship stem from? Are you going for worship because your friends are going to be there? Are you going for worship because this church uses piano, or they get the speakers from abroad? No, because when you make such things the preference of your worship, the minute they're taken away, then you no longer feel the urge to go and worship. However, your preference of worship should be born out of a personal and individual experience with God. Your preference of worship should be built on a solid rock that cannot be moved. We can achieve a unity in our different ways of worship by considering these three P's, and mostly remembering that it is not about us, and worship is not about how we feel, worship is not about who we like and who we do not like, and worship is certainly not about the kind of atmosphere that we prefer. It is about God. Everything at the end of the day boils down to the Creator himself. And I'd like to leave you with one question. How can you tell that you're making worship about you? Because sometimes we forget, and a little pride seeps in when we realize that we do it better than another person. Thank you.